So hello everyone and a very good morning to all of you. Welcome back once again to the session of PIB 247 where we are going to discuss some more questions from the PIB news which are relevant for the ESI section of RBI Grade B exam and NABARD exam. So let's begin with the session guys, but before we begin, if you are new here, do subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon, and also you can join this Telegram group for daily quizzes and updated information about the daily session, or iska link you will get in the description. So let's begin with the very first question, which is about a scheme that has recently been approved by the Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs. That's very important news guys, you should remember this. So consider the following statements regarding newly approved industrial development scheme for Jammu and Kashmir, and you have to identify the correct statements. And in fact question number 2 is also based on the same. So now let's talk about the scheme that has been approved by the Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs. Now you have to tell me who chairs the Cabinet Committee on Economic Affairs. Write down in the comments. So what is the basic objective of this this scheme? To develop industries. Jammu and Kashmir mein industries ka development is ka basic objective, and thereby generating employment for the youth and for the other sectors as well. Alright. So the basic objective guys of this scheme is to develop industries, thereby generating employment. Alright. And who is implementing ministry? That will be Ministry of Commerce and Industry. Ministry of Commerce and Industry will be the implementing ministry, and the total estimated cost is how much? ₹28,400 crore for a period starting from this financial year, that is 2020-21 to 2036-37. Yani ki up to 31st March 2037, total 28,400 crores will be spent on this scheme in development of industries in the Union Territory of Jammu and Kashmir. And of course, Manoj Sinha is the Lieutenant Governor of Jammu and Kashmir. And now these are some guys incentives. There are 3 or 4 incentives that will be provided under this scheme by the Government of India, and these are very important. Let's talk about them. Number 1 is capital investment incentive. Jo capital person invest karega, uske upar jo incentive milega. Let's talk about this. So 30% incentive in zone A, while 50% in zone B. Now what is this zone A and zone B? So zone B guys basically are the far off areas, the far flung areas, okay, the outer areas of any district or any, you know, city. So zone B are the far off areas. The investor will get 50% incentive, while in the zone A the 30% incentive will be provided on the investment made in plant and machinery in the manufacturing sector or any building in the service sector. All right and units with an investment up to ₹50 crores will be eligible. Jo टोटल वैल्यू है यूनिट की वो 50 करोड़ से ज्यादा नहीं होनी चाहिए. एंड द मैक्सिमम इंसेंटिव दैट विल बी प्रोवाइडेड इज विल बी हाउ मच? ₹5 करोड़ इन जोन ए, व्हाइल इन जोन बी इट विल बी ₹7.5 करोड़. ओके, 5 करोड़ होगा मैक्सिमम इंसेंटिव, होगा 5 करोड़ रुपए और जोन ए में, व्हाइल 7.5 करोड़ इन जोन बी. ओके, सो दिस इज द कैपिटल इन्वेस्टमेंट इंसेंटिव. Now moving ahead to the next incentive, which is the GST linked incentive, which means the incentive that will be provided on GST. GST ke upar incentive diya jayega, and how much? 3% of the eligible value. Now guys, this eligible value term, this term has not been clarified by the government. So in future agar kuch clarification hoga, then I'll tell you. 30% of the 300% of the eligible value of the actual investment made on the plant and machinery in the manufacturing sector or any building in the service sector. Okay, and the amount of incentive in a financial year will not exceed 1/10 of the total eligible amount of incentive. Jo total eligible amount hoga incentive ka, 300% of the eligible value, that will be provided in a span of 10 years. Okay, 10 saalon mein diya jayega, aur ek financial year mein total eligible incentive ka 1/10 se zyada nahi ho sakta. All right and moving ahead to the next incentive, which is the working capital interest incentive. So all existing units jo already existing hai, they will be provided with the capital interest incentive at the annual rate of 5% for maximum 5 years, 5 saalon ke liye, and the maximum limit for the incentive is how much? ₹1 crore. So capital interest pe incentive hai, GST linked incentive hai, then we have working capital interest incentive also, then capital interest subvention bhi hai. Okay, isme kya hoga? इंटरेस्ट सबवेंशन बेसिकली दिया जाएगा एट द एनुअल रेट ऑफ 6% फॉर मैक्सिमम 7 इयर्स. ठीक है, 7 सालों के लिए, मैक्सिमम 7 इयर्स के लिए इंटरेस्ट सबवेंशन विल बी प्रोवाइडेड एट द एनुअल रेट ऑफ 6% ऑन द लोन, which can be up to rupees 500 crore, maximum 500 crore tak ke loan pe hi milega for investment made in plant and machinery in the manufacturing sector, while for the buildings and other physical assets in the service sector. Okay, so these are guys are the four incentives that will be provided under this scheme. One is capital investment incentive, then we have GST linked incentive, and number three we have working capital interest incentive, then we have capital interest subvention. Okay, so I hope guys this scheme is clear, and now let's come back to question number 1 and question number 2. So you have to identify the correct statement regarding this scheme. The implementing ministry would be the Ministry of Finance. So is that Ministry of Finance? No, that's Ministry of Commerce and Industry. Okay, Ministry of Commerce and Industry, which is currently headed by Mr. Piyush Goyal. Maximum limit of incentive in zone A is rupees 7.5 crore. So in zone B it is 7.5 crore, while in zone A it is 5 crore, which means this statement is also incorrect. And the maximum limit of working capital interest incentive is how much? Rupees 5 crore. So that is not 5 crore, that is rupees 1 crore, which means this statement is also incorrect. So we have all the statements incorrect here, and we have to identify the correct statement. So therefore the correct answer should be what? Option D. None is correct. Okay. And now moving to the question number 2, what is the total estimated expenditure of the newly approved scheme for J&K? So the total approved expenditure guys is how much? Rupees 28,400 crores. Okay, option A, 28,400 crores will be the correct answer. Okay, and now let's move on to question number 3. So question number 3 says, Union Education Minister, who is Dr. Ramesh Pokhariyal Nishank, has recently inaugurated a 2-day virtual international conference which is known as EduCon for discussing the emerging trends in education. So, ye 2 din ka international virtual conference hai jiska naam hai EduCon, that has been inaugurated by Union Education Minister. So, the question is, which university has organized this conference? Kaun si university ne isko organize kiya tha? This question guys can be asked in your 1 marker. So let's talk about this news. So this EduCon 2020, okay, they are naming it as 2020, okay. EduCon 2020 has been inaugurated by Union Education Minister Dr. Ramesh Pokhariyal Nishank. It is basically a 2-day international virtual conference, and this conference has the objective, it will provide a platform to the researchers and educationists to present their ideas, to present their views on how India can implement the national education policy in a effective manner. Okay, jo hamari national education policy, new education policy hai 2020 mein jo launch hui thi, usko kis tarike se properly effectively implement kar sakte hain, uske liye apne idea share kiye jayenge during this international conference. Okay, and it is being guys organized by Central University of Punjab, which is of course located in Bathinda. And it has a theme also which is envisioning education for transforming youth to realize global peace. Okay, so this is the theme. You should remember the theme also. Aur isme thinkers, researchers, associates kahan kahan ke honge? From the United Kingdom, from Canada, Thailand, USA, Australia, Bhutan and India. Okay, so this was about this news, and therefore the correct answer should be what? So we have to identify the university which has organized this conference. So that's Central University of Punjab, which is located in Bathinda. All right, and now let's move on to question number 4. This question guys is very important because this is based on a report, and this report studies the effect of air pollution on pregnancy, and this is the first ever report of this kind. So let's talk about this question first. Consider the following statements regarding a study based on effect of air pollution on pregnancy published in Lancet, and you have to identify the correct statement regarding this report. So let's talk about this report, and remember that's this is important because it has been published in Lancet, which is a very important journal. Okay, so this is a first ever report which studies about the effect of air pollution on pregnancy, and according to this report there are various cases of pregnancy loss due to air pollution in 3 countries, which are India, Pakistan and Bangladesh. Okay, इंडिया, पाकिस्तान और बांग्लादेश में एयर पोल्यूशन का प्रेगनेंसी लॉस के ऊपर या प्रेगनेंसी के ऊपर काफी ज्यादा इफेक्ट है, ऐसा इस रिपोर्ट ने बताया है. एंड दिस रिपोर्ट गाइस एग्जामिन्स हाउ एक्सपोजर टू पीएम 2.5 इंक्रीजेस द चांसेस ऑफ प्रेगनेंसी लॉस. ओके, जो प्रेगनेंसी लॉस के चांसेस है वो बढ़ जाते हैं ड्यू टू द एक्सपोजर ऑफ पीएम 2.5, ऐसा इसने एग्जामिन किया है, इसने स्टडी किया है. एंड हाउ दिस स्टडी हैज बीन डन, सो बाय कैलकुलेटिंग रिस्क फॉर ईच 10 माइक्रोग्राम पर मीटर क्यूब इंक्रीज ऑफ पीएम 2.5. बेसिकली जो पीएम 2.5 है उसका 10 माइक्रोग्राम पर मीटर क्यूब के बढ़ जाने से प्रेगनेंसी लॉस पे कितना इफेक्ट आता है. दिस वॉज स्टडीड इन दिस रिपोर्ट एंड दिस रिपोर्ट सेज दैट ईच इंक्रीज इन 10 माइक्रोग्राम पर मीटर क्यूब वॉज एस्टिमेटेड टू इंक्रीज अ मदर्स रिस्क ऑफ प्रेगनेंसी लॉस बाय 3%. 10 माइक्रोग्राम पर मीटर क्यूब अगर पीएम 2.5 बढ़ जाता है तो प्रेगनेंसी लॉस के जो चांसेस है वो 3% ज्यादा हो जाते हैं. ओके एंड द इंक्रीज इन रिस्क गाइज वॉज ग्रेटर फॉर मदर्स फ्रॉम द रूरल एरियाज और दोज हु बिकेम प्रेगनेंट एट दी यू नो लेटर एज. ओके ऑफ द प्रेगनेंसी लॉस केसेस 77% फ्रॉम अवर प्यारा भारत, 12% फ्रॉम पाकिस्तान एंड 11% फ्रॉम बांग्लादेश. राइट so this is guys a very important report. You should remember some basic facts about this report. Like you should remember that this increase in 10 microgram per meter cube will increase the chances of pregnancy losses by 3%. It has been published in Lancet journal. Okay so therefore now let's move on to question number 4. Okay so you have to identify the correct statements regarding this report. This report has the study of effect of PM10 and PM2.5 on pregnancy loss. So guys, इसमें PM10 की बात नहीं कही है. There was no introduction of PM10 here. There was only PM2.5. So which means this statement is incorrect. Of the total pregnancy loss cases, 77% were from India. This is absolutely correct. The study says that each increase in 10 microgram per meter cube was estimated to increase a mother's risk of pregnancy loss by 3%. Yes, this is also correct, and we have to identify the correct statement. So therefore, guys, option B. Only 2 and 3 will be the correct answer here. And remember one thing that recently in Britain, first person to die officially because of air pollution was Ella Addu Kissi Debra. All right, Ella Addu Kissi Debra. She was a 9-year-old child. She died of air pollution officially. And she was the first person to die officially because of air pollution in Britain. Okay. And now let's move on to guys question number 5, which is the last question for today. Where has the centralized network lab of Coalition for Epidemic Preparedness Innovation, which in short is CEPI, been inaugurated? So, ye India mein aisi pehli lab bani hai. This is first of its kind lab in India. And one of the 7 in world. Duniya mein 7 aisi labs aur hain, jisme 7th lab jo hai ye India mein bani hai. Aur India mein pehli aisi lab bani hai. And this is basically a centralized network lab of CEPI, and CEPI stands for Coalition for Epidemic Preparedness Innovation. So let's talk about this. And this lab, guys, has been inaugurated at the Translation Health Science and Technology Institute, which is located in Faridabad. Okay, in Faridabad, of course, is in Haryana. Translation Health Science and Technology Institute. So you should remember the name of the institute where this lab has been inaugurated, and this has been accredited by NABL also. Now, what is this CEPI? Let's talk about this CEPI. What is this? So, it is basically a partnership between public, between private, between philanthropists, between the civil societies, between the NGOs. So, in sabhi ka ye broad partnership hai that was launched in Davos in Switzerland in 2017. And what is the basic objective of this partnership? Kyun ki gayi thi ye partnership? To develop vaccines to stop future epidemics. Aane wale epidemics ko rokne ke liye. वैक्सीन की डेवलपमेंट के लिए दिस पार्टनरशिप वॉज डन इन 2017 इन डावोस. ओके एंड द डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ बायोटेक्नोलॉजी ऑफ इंडिया इज इम्प्लीमेंटिंग द इंड सेपी मिशन. ओके एंड व्हाट इज द नेम ऑफ दिस मिशन? इंडिया सेंट्रिक एपिडेमिक प्रिपेयरनेस थ्रू रैपिड वैक्सीन डेवलपमेंट. नाउ व्हाट इज द बेसिक एम? सो एज द नेम सजेस्ट, द बेसिक एम इज टू डेवलप द वैक्सीन एंड टू सेव इंडिया फ्रॉम द फ्यूचर एपिडेमिक्स और द फ्यूचर पैंडेमिक्स. ऑलराइट so this was about this news, and now let's come back to the question. So you have to tell where has this network, this lab has been inaugurated. Okay, so it was inaugurated at guys Translation Health Science and Technology Institute, which is located in Faridabad. Okay, so that's it for the session. I hope all the questions are clear. If you have any doubts, you can ask me in the comment section. Thank you so much for watching. Goodbye, take care, and God bless.